Let me give you a guided tour. Let us learn some more. Welcome back to my channel, I'm the Amastorian. And this episode is gonna be on Rindö Redutt. Now that, what does Redutt means? Well, Rindö is the name of the island. And Redutt, well, there are different versions of, or languages that this word comes from. French, Redutt. Italian, Ridotto, or Ridotta. And Google Translate tells me that in English it's called a redutt, or something like it. I'm gonna use this Swedish word here, redutt, okay? So bear with me on that. So what is a redutt? Well, it's a small freestanding fortress without flanking defenses. Basically, it's a small fortification that is not a main fortification, but it's a smaller one that is supposed to help something bigger or something like that. And Rindö Redutt was built in between the years 1858 and 1863 by the fortifications engineer Johan of Kleen. The Rindö Redutt was made to actually overlook the Vaxholm citadell and help in the defense of that strait. So this was actually constructed at the same time as the Vaxholm citadell was remade. If you want to learn more about that, check out my other video on Vaxholm citadell. The redutt is dominated by the donjon, meaning the heavily reinforced red brick and granite barracks. Which is meant as a part of the defense. The normal meaning of the term donjon would be the highest point of a castle, of usually the keep. But it can also mean a heavily fortified barrack that is meant for the defense. And the longest barrack that is meant for defense, and therefore called the donjon, would be the donjon the castle of Karlsborg, or the fortress of Karlsborg. Rindö Redutt has two caponeries, which combined with the donjon gives 360 degrees cannon fire to lace the outside of the walls and the dry moat. And this is quite important to clear out the moat and the outside of the wall so the enemy cannot hug up against the wall. Basically, the caponeries gives the same effect as a machicolation does, but you can use it parallel to the wall and therefore have the same effect, but you can use the cannons or higher firepower in there. Basically, make sure the enemy cannot hide behind a wooden frame with something to repel your attacks. Outside the dry moat, there is a field of rocks that was blasted out when the redutt was built. These are placed in a way that makes this field so difficult to cross as possible. You really don't want to run around in this, because you're gonna break your ankles pretty fast. It makes basically the same effect as the dragon's teeth that was made in, I think, the First and Second World War. And these things are nasty! Oh, they are so nasty. And so effective. The bridge and road that is leading right across these blasted rocks, the storm defenses, as they are called, is of a later date that was built way after this fortress lost its military importance and was built for convenience for people nowadays. So that bridge is not original. Think that away when you see the pictures of this fortress. So what was the problems with this fortress? Well, the main problem is that it's built in the same time and in the same way as the citadel. Because 1872, there was a test fire done by the HMS Hilder, which used a 240mm cannon to fire on the Vaxholm citadel. And that made it abundantly clear that this type of fortress and walls just didn't work anymore. The new rifled cannons just sliced through these walls. So this fortress was outdated when it was built. And that sucks. Because it's the main purpose of the fortress. The main purpose of this fortress was not possible to use it for, because the walls doesn't hold up against the new cannons that was in use by then. So the way they fixed this was to build the 12th battery in front of Rindö Redutt, and that is basically a... Well, what is it? Well, it's a more of a modern bunker blasted out of the bedrock and cannons. More modern cannons. But more on those in a later video. And that's gonna be it for now. And I thank you all for watching. As always, you can find me on YouTube as the Amastorian. And on Facebook as the Amastorian. Like, share, subscribe, and I see you later. Bye bye.
Thanks so much for watching. Like and subscribe.